Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco and today I'm going to be talking about camera sequencer in Max. In case you never heard of camera sequencer in Max, I don't blame you, because Max is known to have super inviting names of, you know, very, very actually useful features, like, I don't know, data channel, for example. Who would not want to click on that, right? Anyhow, camera sequencer in Max is basically a video montage tool directly in Max. So, for example, here in After Effects, I've rendered out 4 shots and I've just, you know, did a quick montage of them just to see, you know, how my camera transitions are working, are they looking good, etc. But the problem is, whenever you're doing these, you know, like sequence exports, like how many times you would have a scenario where you would like check the 2 files in your video editing software and, you know, like camera was too fast, too slow or something, then you have to go back to Max, tweak it there and then export again and import here, etc., etc. Well, what if I told you that this whole timeline thing with sequences, you actually already have that in Max. It's actually built in. Voila, this is the camera sequencer. Check this out. Just play your stuff and you can directly look at how your cameras work, like are the speeds okay, etc. And best of all is you can directly tweak your cameras for the each sequence and you can do your montages live again in Max directly. Let me show you how you can access this and how, you know, and some basic functionalities of it. But before we start, I just want to point out that the scene used in my Max is Evermotion's Arc Interiors Volume 66, Offices and Galleries. So yeah, you can check that out on Evermotion website. So I've imported my lovely Evermotion scene in my Max, and as you can see here, I have 4 cameras. All 4 cameras are animated, so to activate the camera sequencer, you want to go to the rendering menu and then click on the camera sequencer. So camera sequencer will appear here, but it will appear here for me because I docked it down there, because by default, it will be probably floating somewhere around in your Max. I just placed it down and that's why it's there. Now, to start adding your cameras here, or how it looked like in After Effects, you know, just to add those sequences, you can just click this plus button. Since I have 4 cameras, I'm gonna hit this 4 times and each of these lines is a separate sequence. So here where it says none, you wanna add your first camera. When you click on the first camera, your first sequence will appear. Now, if I add my second one, third, and fourth, you got your 4 sequences. All of them, as you can see here in the middle, all of them have 50 frames. Now, you can resize that, you can just move that around, do whatever you like with them. My camera 1 is my beginning, like opening shot, and my camera 4 is my closing shot. So I'm gonna move my camera 4 to the very end, like here, and I also want that camera shot to be longer, so I'm just gonna extend it to, I don't know, 80 frames here. Now, I also want my first shot to be also longer, so I'm gonna set my first shot also to 80. So I can just move the slider here and just, you know, try to hit the number 80, or you can just double click on the number 50 and just define how long you want the duration to be. So let's say 0 to 80, click OK, and you got this. Now, for the other shots, I'm just gonna place this one here and place this one there, and now you can just move and kind of snap them. One cool thing is, if you select your first shot, hold the control key and select the second one, you can actually move both of them. So you can now adjust them to have roughly the same duration. So, okay, 61, 62, that's all fine. So that's practically it. That's how this whole sequencer works. So take a look at this. And now when I hit play, I can actually see how my animation looks like with all the camera transitions and everything directly in Max. And if there are any things that I need to tweak, I can tweak them right here. One thing that I noticed is when I go to my second shot and like near the end, my camera stops. So you can see here, I'm scrubbing the timeline here and it just stops. So now if you double click on your sequence, it will tell you what camera that is. Actually, it will select the whole camera. So this is camera number 2. And since my camera and my target are animated, in my layers, I'm just gonna select my cam 2 and my target, and I'm gonna get these keyframes. So it's frame 0 and frame whatever this is. So now, if I go here, that means that my sequence is lasting up to 142nd frame. So I can now move all these keyframes here. As a matter of fact, I can actually make this a little bit faster. So I'm just gonna, you know, squeeze tightly the keyframes. Let's say something like this. And now I can easily check how my scene flow just works. So yeah, I think this generally performs nicely. One thing that I noticed here now is that this shot is very slow. So like comparing the speed of this one and then just this one, I think this one could be a little bit faster. So I'm just gonna double click here just so that I know which camera it is. So it's camera 3, and I'm just gonna select camera 3 and the target, and I see these keyframes. So these keyframes are dedicated to this. So I'm just gonna move them forward in time, and I'm just gonna select the first group of keyframes and just make it a little bit more faster. And now if I go back in time and just play my animation, you can see that these shots just fit much more nicely with each other. They even match with the last shot. But now, Camera Sequencer has much more features than what I've just shown. So one of the cool things that you can do, you see here where it says shot 4, 3, 2, 1, you have these little round icons. These are record buttons. So take a look at this. This scene, like this monitor and this chair, those are the objects from this position. So that's that chair and that's that monitor, right? So what I can do, so if for some reason I, for example, don't want to see, I don't know, this chair, you see like this chair in the back in this shot, what I can do, so since this is my cam 3, I can just click on this round button, like record button, and now whatever I do will get recorded. So if I go right click and just hide selected, and now if I turn off my recording, and now if I play the previous scene, we got the chair here. On the next shot, it's not there, and then on our last shot, it's still there. So that's the magic part that you can do. You can change materials, you can record a lot of stuff. So that's the state sets part. With state sets, you can do a lot of things. Now when it comes to rendering all this, you generally want to, you know, open up render setup, make sure that active time segment is turned on, and then here where it says state sets, right click and you have render all states, then all frames are going to be rendered. If you want to render chunks of this, I actually don't know if there is a smart way of doing that. The way I've been always doing it is just click on the range here and then define the range. So for example, from 0 to 80, I would just type 0, 80, and I would just hit render and just render chunks, and that's how I would separate things. I guess that there is a smarter way of doing it. I was just too lazy to explore that. But when it comes to rendering previews of this, you know, your client has to see things first. Well, for that, I use the preview maker from Tyflow. So I would just go to tools and then preview, grab preview, and then you have create type preview. So when you click on that, make sure to just have active time segment, set your render destination, and just click create preview. Now, Tyflow will nicely render out your preview, and you will get the preview of your whole animation as an MP4 file, which you can directly send to your client, and hopefully you will not get changes on it. And that's generally how Camera Sequencer works. So it was like a basic introduction, but I think a lot can be done with whatever is shown here. So I hope this will actually make your workflows much easier. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Evermotion, thank you for sponsoring this video, and see you in the next one. Bye!